oh my god, this music is too soft for me. Get it out of here.
There's like this weird static sound that goes on in the background of my audio and I have no idea how to fix it. What's up guys, my name is Savette. I talk about whenever I want to on my channel. Third time I've said that intro, by the way. And today I wanted to talk about flexibility and safety when it comes to visual cape bands. Because this is roughly my second or third time recording this, I'm gonna be straightforward in my approach. Before I was like completely emotional. That was mostly because Dadaroma 7 days ago announced that they were disbanding and I was in my feelings. From what I understand, Yoshiatsu said that he wanted Dadaroma's name to not be tarnished, I guess in so many words. And I personally think what he meant was because the most recent album wasn't well received by older Dadaroma fans, he didn't want to be that band that's just like, oh, they used to be good, but now they're not good anymore because they changed. I feel like he made that call so they could go and work on other projects, whether they're working on projects together or whether they're working on projects in other bands separately. Visual K fans specifically have this thing where they don't ever expect Visual K bands to change. They love seeing the costume changes. They love seeing the outfit changes, the makeup changes. They love seeing all those changes. But when it comes to a change in the sound, everybody completely freaks out and it's ridiculous. It's like Visual K bands, the members aren't seen as people. People, especially creative people, don't want to stay the same all the time. They want to be able to branch out and do different things and explore different sounds, especially because as they get older, the sounds that they like change. If you are a younger Visual K fan, the music that you like is going to change. If it doesn't change, then that's rare. That's really, really rare. But just like you change, the type of music that they want to make changes, and they should be allowed to make these types of changes without giving up their name. And listen, I completely understand. There are some bands that I adore with all my heart. Like, I post pictures of them all the time on Tumblr, and I don't listen to their current music that they make right now because it's a little bit too soft for me. Two examples, I guess, could be Yudagamesh before they broke up. The last album that I bought for them was Now, and then after that, I was like, okay, the sound is not really to my liking. I really, really like Muck, but I don't really listen to their music anymore. I get wishing a band hadn't changed their sound, but there's a complete difference between not liking a band's sound and then tearing down a band and calling them bad or not as good as they used to be just because they changed their sound to appeal to a broader audience. You should be happy. Their change in sound is attracting more people to their music. Their art is not yours. It's for you to enjoy, and of course they market it in a way where it seems like it's yours, but at the end of the day, you are there to enjoy something that they made. So if they make something that you don't like, that doesn't make them suddenly trash. It just means that they're not aligning with your taste, so you need to go somewhere else. Dadaroma specifically, I was really shocked when they announced that they'd be breaking up because I really feel like they were just now building a broader audience. But dealing with Visual K fans, you are musically in a box. Instead of tarnishing Dadaroma's image in that way as the band that used to be good but not as good anymore because they softened their sound, he was like, you know what? I think we're done here. I think we've done everything we can do as Dadaroma. And that decision made sense, even though it made me very, very sad. They've been working really, really hard. I like all the members, and whatever projects that they move on to next, I will definitely be following because they don't strike me as the type of people that are done with music. That is just my opinion. Maybe there's some other internal issues that I'm not aware of, but I personally think that Yoshiatsu made that call because of how their most recent album was received by older Dadaroma fans. I think they're interested in making other types of music. It's just really, really disappointing that they had to do what they had to do. All this creativity, and then when you start to develop your own things and like change things, suddenly everybody loses their mind. Only reason why I feel like I have a little bit more of an understanding of these types of things is because I'm older. You know, I grew up listening to Visual K. My perspective is very, very different. Even hearing about Hizumi from Despairsray starting his new project, how Despairsray ended because his vocals being messed up. You want these members to keep the same hard, screamy sound, and they literally can't physically keep up with the music that you guys expect from them consistently for years and years and years and years. Don't you want the bands that you love to be able to continue making music in the long run? Like, I've recently been listening to a lot of Lunacy and Bucktick Lives. Ryuichi and Atsushi sound amazing for groups that were the starting foundation in the beginning of Visual K. To hear that their voices are still intact and are still beautiful, even more beautiful than they used to be, that gives me the ultimate satisfaction. And that is what you should want.
The reason why some of the founding Visual K bands can do what they do, the reason why their vocals are intact, is because they didn't really do those harder sounds that we expect other Visual K bands to do consistently for like 5, 10, 15 years. That's a whole nother subject. I'm just saying all these things need to be considered. The first thing that we need to start doing is humanizing these creatives.
You should want the best for all of these people that you claim to care about.
I understand because pop and hip hop is so popular, people are starving for heavier music and heavier sounds, but if the band that you love is not making that sound anymore, go on to the next band. Don't tear the band down and say they suck just because they've grown and want to make other different sounds. If you really love these bands, you would want them to be successful, you would want them to be popular, even if it's not exactly beneficial anymore to you. I'm talking about flexibility. So another group that I want to bring up is DIMLIM. I recently became a fan of DIMLIM with their Miscellaneous album. I think MISC is Miscellaneous, correct me if I'm wrong, but I really enjoyed the album, and there were a lot of DIMLIM fans that were just like, this album sucks. And I'm just like, what? What I just listened to sucks? Are you kidding me? It was a very well done, complex album. DIMLIM is an example of a band that is going through that change where the Visual K fans are really upset with them, like their original fans. The difference is they did it at a surprisingly faster pace than other bands. Other bands that have softened up their sound, the softening was gradual, but DIMLIM, they softened their stuff up quite a bit and they have not been out that long. The image of DIMLIM has definitely changed since the first type of music that they started making, whatever kind of core that was, because I actually am in the process of reviewing DIMLIM. I did not like any of their previous albums before the Miscellaneous album. Not to kick anybody who likes that type of music, but I've long passed that age. I do think DIMLIM is a perfect example of artists that clearly want to go in another direction and fans aren't taking it well. A lot of the fans that I've seen of the Miscellaneous album are newer fans. A lot of the older ones think the album sucks, which it doesn't. I understand that you're upset, but it's just like, people aren't gonna keep making the same type of music, especially since the kind of music that they were making, wow, you guys are gonna hate me for this. If you're a DIMLIM fan, like of their older stuff, you're gonna hate me for this, but especially since the older stuff that they were making, Chiyodara, like whatever album that was, there is a demand for it, but is it unique? Is it interesting? Not really. I just think that DIMLIM is an example of what Dadaroma would have to do if they continued on making music. Only with DIMLIM, they've decided that they're just gonna continue making music. I think that's a wise choice on Show's part, because with the music that they're creating now, I do think they have the potential to get bigger. I personally feel like the direction that DIMLIM is going into is more interesting than what I saw before. Even when it comes to making heavier music, you can still tell when a band has talent. Based on the interview that was recently translated, I think Show was very tired of the music that they were making, and I think that is an example of how a lot of Visual K artists really feel, but are either scared to actually go through with the change, or go through with the change, lose their original fan base, and end up, you know, disbanding later on and kind of feeling not as happy about everything that they've made so far. I have a lot of other things to say about DIMLIM as a band, but I'm actually reviewing them for my next video, so I will talk about the members a little bit more in that video rather than this one. Even if DIMLIM decided to drop whatever sound they had now and go back to their original sound, I wouldn't hold it against the band, because a lot of people really hated their recent album, and I don't understand it. I thought it sounded nice. It kind of reminded me of Ling Toste Sigure a little bit, and the way the music is composed and put together is very beautiful. Maybe it's because I'm out of touch with the genre, but I really don't need screaming or growling to enjoy Visual K bands. I do like heavier sounds, but I don't need it. Literally, I was reading this blog where one Visual K fan said they only listen to music with screaming in it. I almost died laughing. Like, I literally could not stop laughing, because it's like, what type of energy? You're hardcore, huh? You're the edgiest of the edgiest person. Oh my god, this music is too soft for me. Get it out of here. I can't. I mean, I get a lot of Visual K fans are younger, so I understand, but calm yourself. It's okay. Like, you can like other music, like, it is okay. So since my battery is low, I'm gonna quickly run through the safety thing. A while ago, but not that long ago, I actually don't remember the exact date, but Acme did a tour in North America, and guess what happened to Beautiful Them? They got robbed. They got all of their instruments taken. I was at work when I found out, and I was furious. And since then, I have not seen any Visual K bands schedule an American tour, unless it was in connection with like an anime convention. And I don't think that is a coincidence. Visual K is very niche. The community kind of strikes me as a very tight-knit community. So I just feel like we won't be seeing a lot of Visual K bands announcing tours in America unless it's under something that can protect them for a while. To want to go and reach your international fans and to have to worry about your safety, whether you're gonna get robbed, whether you're gonna get hurt, I really, really feel for Acme. That's something that they shouldn't have had to go through. To get their instruments taken, I don't think a Visual K fan would rob them, but it's still unsettling to know that bands can't come here and perform safely. Keep that in mind. If you don't hear about Visual K bands coming to America or scheduling tours to America, do remember that Acme just got robbed a few months ago. I wouldn't be surprised if bands didn't feel safe here. When you're bigger bands like the Gazette and you're under Sony or you're Hyde, you know, you're gonna have protection. But for the smaller bands like Acme, where they're not super huge, it's just really, really unfortunate. And watching DIMLIM schedule tours, watching Mook schedule a tour, like watching all these bands schedule tours all over the place, but not schedule tours here, I was kind of just like, I wonder if that kind of has anything to do with it. Of course, I don't think it's set in stone. I just think it's kind of crazy that they have to consider their safety that much before coming to perform for American fans specifically. Sometimes I think of that when I think about Kizu coming here, and I'm just like, I really want Kizu to come here. I felt that way about Dadaroma too, but they had to go and disband. I guess I'll just have to follow the members wherever they go. I mean, I guess. But yeah, that's all I really wanted to talk about. I just want Visual K fans to treat Visual K artists with a little bit more humanity. These bands don't suddenly suck just because they're not making the music you like. You suck. I'm joking, you don't suck. But I guess there's also the small factor that they are in Japan and they do have to appeal to the Japanese ear. Japan's really on the pop electronic thing, so that's something that should also be considered when bands change their sound. I do think that the end goal is for them to make something that they actually like and make something that can reach a certain audience. There's various reasons why bands do things that they do. The important thing is to remember nobody wants to do the same thing over and over and over again. I have no doubt in my mind that a lot of Visual K bands feel connected to their original fans that were there from the beginning. But to see those fans tear them down and to slowly fade out, like, I know it has to hurt for those bands. I'm not going to continue rambling on. I am about to go eat. Peace out, guys.